Hi everyone and welcome back. I'm Johan Nemes and in this video I'll show you how I destack the Comet Neowise in Deepskystacker. So first plan, I had a few hundred images that I used also for the video, and I destacked part of these images that I took with my Skywatcher ED80. I did set the position of the Comet manually, and I tried also median and Kappa-Sigma clipping method for the light frames when I stacked standard stacking on stars or stars and comet. My recommendation, try all the options in Deepskystacker. Try comet stacking, standard stacking and stars and comet stacking, because I've noticed standard stacking on stars worked really good, better than stars and comet stacking option. In this case for the Comet Neowise, it was a little bit weird. I thought that it would work better stars and comet stacking. So let's see how I stack both images, and let's watch together the results. With the images that I took with my telescope, I had good results using comet stacking and standard stacking on stars. Was very interesting that stars and comet stacking did not work, but I did get some nice results on the first two options. I did use the main group for the short exposures of 3 seconds, and the group one for the 10 seconds exposures and 20 seconds. And also I used a reference frame. I tried two images. First one did not have very good results because it cropped from the image. I will show you now how it looks. So you see the image is cropped. So I decided to select other images reference, and it worked fine. I did stack more of the image with the comet. And these are the results on comet stacking. I decided in the end to go with the standard stacking. It was a little bit unusual, but it did stack very good. Then I used my Nikon 40mm lens with another camera, Nikon D3200, and I did capture in the rural area the Comet Neowise, and I did made around 60 images. I used 8 seconds and I saw 1600 at f2.8. I really got some nice results in a rural area. First I registered the images, then after I registered and I went here and compute the number of detected stars, it found 350 or something like this at 5%, so it was okay. Then I went here, edit comet mode, and I zoomed in with the mouse scroll, clicked here to select the position on every image. You can do this also on the first one and the last one, last light frame, if you select here the end time. But I did select the position, I placed here in the center and select the position on all the comets just to be sure. And here it will show you the stars, the number of stars detected plus comet. So you can check here in this area to be sure you have selected the comet. Let's check the settings again. Stacking settings, I'll go comet, I will leave standard mode. On comet stacking, I will select average. But on standard stacking and stars and comet, I think I'll go with median. I could go also try Kappa-Sigma clipping. No drizzle, because drizzle might affect the image stacking in Deepskystacker with comets. At least on my first try with comet atlas, it did affect. This one I will remove also, the 10 seconds, okay. So cancel, okay, registered. They are already registered, so I'll press okay. So 3 minutes and 44. Standard stacking, align on stars. Let's press okay, and let's see the results. Okay, I will show you the image in a few moments after it will finish stacking. So it did stack really fast, and I'm really curious on the results. Let's increase the lighting first. Okay. And move the RGB levels just a little. Okay, like so. And also in the highlights, and hit apply. So much, much better. Maybe just 22.8. So yeah, this is better. So we have nice details here. Maybe with the saturation I could go 15. Let's try 15. Let's hit apply. Okay. So I leave the saturation to 15. I selected standard stacking and this stack also the comet good. So this is nice, very nice. Save picture to file. And 16. So it's saved. Now let's do another one. Let's go here and open picture files, then cancel. We are back in. I choose this as reference, this one. I think also choosing the reference, it might help. Let's go first at stacking settings, and I'll go Stars+Comet. Let's try now this one and see the difference. Okay, and here I will leave Kappa-Sigma. Let's see. So registered. I do not have to register again because they are already registered. And now I'll press OK. So 28 images. So now it will stack. So it did finish stacking. So now we are back on the Stars and Comet stack. And let's see. Let's get more light here. So move the layers, I have here linked. Okay, so now it's good. Brightness, I'll go to 24. And it looks good now. And I can see here also the second tail. So, Stars and Comet did work okay. So, let's go open picture files. Cancel, and I'll go here at the stack at settings, stacking settings. I will select comet stacking, light, average. So this works best when you want star trails. Then press OK and register check pictures. I do not need to register because they are already registered. And stack and align on comet. So let's see the image. I will leave it to process, and in a few moments I'll show you the results. Okay, so Deepskystacker finished processing. Now we have the stack on comet, and let's get some light here. Let's see how it looks. Apply. Let's move the RGB levels. Okay. So, stacking on comet, also did stack the stars good. So what to think now? I don't know. Okay, now I will go to saturation. Let's increase also the saturation. So let's apply and see how it looks with more saturation. Let's see highlights, I will go with 60. Editing in Adobe Camera Raw will bring even better results. After I did try all the stacking modes in Deepskystacker, and I edited the images in Adobe Camera Raw and Photoshop, I decided to select as the final image the one that I obtained using the standard stacking. And here is the final result after I edited in Adobe Camera Raw and Photoshop. I also stacked the images that I had for the time-lapse, so I stacked almost 600 images. I tried also standard stacking and it stacked 231 images, but I did got a starless image. Very good quality on the foreground, but on the sky you can see no stars. So let's zoom in a little and look closer. So having so many images, it did failed. Now let's see the comet stacking. So the problem was the comet was here on the left, two on the left. So I had, it is better if you do this to have the comet in the center area and select those frames. Using here a custom rectangle, I managed to stack the comet and the stars, but I did have some problems here in the left side. So here we have the comet stacking, and now we have the standard stacking on stars. And the last mode, comet and stars stacking, did not work. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon in my next video. If you did not subscribe already, please do so you won't miss any of my new videos. And I'll see you soon in the next one. Clear sky.